Early one morning, the Fat Controller came to the sheds to speak with Percy.
"Percy, I need you to take a special visitor on a tour of our line," he said. "He wants to do a few pictures of Sodor, one he calls the Spirit of Sodor. Anyway, I've asked Doc to do your jobs for the day."
"Yes, sir," said Percy nervously.
"Don't be afraid, Percy," said Thomas. "I know you'll give the important visitor a grand tour of our line."
"I should have been given that job," sniffed Gordon. "If it has anything to do with important passengers, then I'm just the engine for the job. Percy will probably get the visitors so angry that they'll complain to the Fat Controller."
"Don't listen to him, Percy. You can do it. You've given passengers great rides before. Remember when you promised to bring the children home during that storm?" Percy smiled.
"Thank you, Thomas. I promise I won't let you or the railway down."
Percy puffed into the dock's light engine. He was hoping that the visitor was going to be friendly. I'm sorry to say that he wasn't. He looked angry as he looked over to Percy.
"What's this?" he asked angrily. "I was hoping for a ride on a diesel-powered train, not a steam relic."
Percy felt hurt, especially when the visitor grumbled about riding in Percy's cab.
"Never mind, Percy," said his driver. "I'm sure he'll calm down once he sees what our island is all about."
This made Percy feel much better as he puffed on his way. He first puffed into Shen Valley. It was a wonderful place to visit. Percy was sure that the artist would paint a picture of the valley. Well, I'm sorry to say that he just grumbled.
"It's too green," he snapped. "Show me something special."
"Yes, sir," said Percy.
He felt offended all over again. The next place Percy and his crew took the artist to was Narnby Beach. There were plenty of people there today, all enjoying the nice warm summer weather.
"What do you think, sir?"
asked Percy.
"Wouldn't you think that Narnby Beach is a great place to paint?"
"This is a joke, right?" snapped the artist. "This place is too yellow, there are too many people here. I told you to show me something special. It's no wonder you steam engines are replaced. You can't do anything right."
Percy's feelings were deeply hurt, but he did agree to show the artist something else. But the artist was a picky man. When Percy showed the viaduct, the artist said,
"Too tall."
then the windmill.
Two round.
He tried many locations, but the artist wasn't happy with any of the places. Each time, he said something terrible about the locations and about Percy.
I wish I had the confidence like Thomas,
whispered Percy to his driver.
Then I can tell this artist that he is wrong.
It's better if you don't, his driver advised. He'll most likely complain to the Fat Controller. Remember, he is famous and important.
At last, Percy pulled into the big station. It was very busy at this time, with engines shunting, passengers boarding trains, and porters loading and unloading.
What about the big station?
Percy asked the artist.
Don't you think this is the best thing to paint?
No, it is not, snapped the artist. There are too many of you claptraps here. If your controller had any sense, he would replace all of you with diesels. At least they are beautiful. Steam engines are rusty buckets on wheels which need to find themselves a scrapyard.
Gordon was nearby. He was about to tell the artist what he thought of him. But he never got the chance as Percy said it for him.
How dare you speak like that about us engines and of our island? Sodor is beautiful and wonderful, and all the engines here are really useful workers. You have no taste in art at all.
Percy was so cross that he blew steam angrily, which blew the artist's hat away.
Well done, Percy, said Gordon. I couldn't have put it better myself.
The Fat Controller had heard everything from his office, just as he was going to have his lunch. He spoke sternly.
Percy, what is the meaning of this?
Well, sir, this man insulted all of us, and...
Percy is right, said the artist. I have been insulting your railway and your island, and I am sorry. To make up for my bad behavior, I will paint a picture of Percy.
Percy was surprised.
You want to paint a picture of me?
Yes, indeed. You are honest, loyal, and not afraid to speak your mind. That's why I want to paint a picture of a great steam engine, with a true artistic view. You truly are the spirit of Sodor.
Percy was pleased. Gordon, however, was speechless. For the rest of the day, Percy stayed where he was while the painter painted his picture. Later that night, the artist revealed the picture.
I knew you were the right engine for the job, smiled Thomas. Maybe we should get an artist's hat for you.
Percy had to chuckle. Still, he was happy to change a person's view of steam engines, and help someone to become a perfect artist.
What a wonderful picture! We'll be right back.